Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting and I'm coming to share with you part 2 with creating this journal. I already finished that large photo frame, that snapshot frame, and I added to that first one. Maybe I will change it. I'm changing it my designs many times before I finish that journal. But this time I wanna do it in vintage style with like specimen or like the specimen is hopefully that right word, theme. So what I create, it's those two labels. I'm not sure if I will use them, but I already created them. They are from Prima Marketing collection, those beautiful labels. This is I think number one. Yeah, here, object labels number one, and I used this and this label. I let them dry, then I used a white acrylic color like my base, and then I used to that finished like vintage look, I used this amazing antique brilliance wax something. This one, and this is mystic turquoise, and when you open it, you see, this is like color which you have when you move that label. It's like shining this color, but the base it's brown like this, and it makes beautiful antique design. So I use it on both, and here I found few my prints from past time, so I already cut those two books, I think it's called books, and I glue it down. I'm not sure which one. I think this is too big for my spine, and it's it's not straight, so I think I'm gonna glue down this one. Yes, maybe I will use this one. I think I will use this label. I found in my stuff, this is glue, I guess. I believe this is glue number 4. It's glue here. It's glue gel here. This is from that Creabox, Marabu Creabox. I found it in Lidl, and it has 4 different mediums, acrylic mediums. It has acrylic primer black, white, and acrylic primer. I think this is acrylic gel, it's probably clear one, and this is like glue, so I'm gonna use this to glue it down. Then I will put it on the side to let it dry. I'm not sure how long time this have to dry, because I never used it before. And I'm also not sure how much I have to put on it. Probably a lot, I guess. Okay, I'm gonna do it this way. Much more easy. Like spread it on that surface everywhere, probably. I'm really not sure how this works. This is first time I'm gonna use this gel. Oops. Oh, I wanted to do. No, I'm gonna do it later. I think here I'm gonna place that label and I'm gonna let it dry. Also that stamp. I'm gonna place it this way. This way I'm gonna place it. Okay. Like this. And that stamp, I'm gonna show you also that stamp. Just bear with me. I'm not gonna be too much bothered about this extra. What is it? I'm losing my English. Oh, I'm not gonna be bothered about this mess, because I wanna create some kind of rusty effect on that. This stamp, it's from beautiful Prima collection. I'm gonna show you the collection I've got. It's these stamps. Where is the name? Where is the name? I'm gonna have a look if I will find some name for pieces. Oh, I have no idea what, but probably this is number. I am really not sure where is the name of these stamps or if this is a number of these stamps. But it looks like this, and I use this this stamp to create this stamping. This video will be very long. I'm gonna put it on the side and let it dry. And we will continue in that middle part. Just bear with me, I'm gonna try that this acrylic mix and that other rest, and I will continue. In that previous very long video, I didn't create too much. So today I'm gonna try to continue. As I showed you before, I've got these two pieces. And I think I'm gonna glue them straight away. Hopefully it will be okay. I'm gonna glue this one. And I'm gonna create my pockets here. So I'm gonna glue this down and I will be back. So I glued down this piece on these three sides. And now I'm gonna create some pockets. I'm gonna take the same envelope I used here and I'm gonna cut it somehow. I already cut this edge and flat it down, these folds. I would like to have here an envelope, like pocket envelope, large pocket envelope, but I would like to have that view. When you open your book, you will have here a nice large pocket, but you will see still pages behind, so it have to be a little bit smaller than it's my cover. So I guess this is 7 inches. That view I want, it's probably like this, to have their beautiful space for pages and maybe for another pocket. So it will be 5.5. I'm gonna put this. Where is my oil? I tidy up too much. Now I can't reach my tools. Okay, I'm gonna cut this and create envelope 5.5 wide. I think it's the right word. Hopefully. Okay. Good. So this is my envelope 5.5 inches. Yeah, I think I cut it smaller, did I? No, 5.5. Show me. I think I created too small. Ah, okay, 5.5. That rest we have 9 and something. 9 3/4. First, I will create tabs on these edges because I would like to have that tab effect. So before I will fold it somehow, I'm gonna create on these edges tabs, and I'm gonna use my tool. This one. My tool I create long time ago. And I think I'm gonna create this negative of that. It will be much more better for me. I'm gonna create one tab on this end. I'm gonna start here like this, and I think I wanna have that tab. I know how long. Here I cut pieces I showed you before, so I wanna have that tab to fit this one like embellishment. So I'm gonna place this here. Yes. And I'm gonna create. Then I will cut these pieces out. Same way I'm gonna create it on that opposite side. Just here I've got that tab here. So on that opposite side, I would like to have that tab on the opposite side. I hope you know what I mean. I am losing my English today. And I think it's because I'm watching so many Czech movies right now. You know, it's Christmas time. We've got our favorites. So I'm watching on and on our Christmas favorites movies from Czech Republic. I'm losing my English. That's no good. So now I'm gonna cut these pieces out like this, and on these corners I use this corner cut, X-cut. Now I need to fold it, and again I would like to have that view of these tabs, so it can't be scored in the half. It have to be scored with one side bigger and another side smaller. And because this is 9.5 now, from the top to the top it's 9.5, so I'm gonna score it at 5. It should be at 5, which means that the rest will be 4.5, and it should be nice. Sorry. Oops, sorry. Noisy. And dangerous. It should be nice view of my tabs. Will that be? We will see. Yes. See? I'm gonna see both tabs. So this way. Now I'm gonna fix it to my background. I'm gonna take this. Here will come my this one, this tape. It will come to the work. I think here I'm gonna round these corners. Also, I will like it more with round corners. Yes, I will like it more. I need to distress all these edges. Distress all edges, and now I'm going to glue it here. To this edge first from inside using my clear tape, because later on I will cover it with newspapers or that book pages anyway, so I don't mind that here will be that tape, but still I wanted to have that distressed look here on that edge. That's why I distress it before. I use this tape from one side. Fold it. And from other side I will put that tape also. Like this. Gonna press it down properly to make sure it will hold all together. Here I wanna see that curved edge, so I'm gonna cut the tape a little bit. And I did it wrong because I wanted this here. Okay. Oopsla. I took wrong part. I'm gonna cut it out just like this, fold it. Now you can see how you can change your mind. Yeah, come on Evie, come on, cut it, good. I'm gonna glue it again, okay, on this side, and it will be same similar way. Oops. Oh my. I'm gonna glue it here. I'm gonna try to make it straight. How I fold it? I don't have it straight here. Why I don't have it straight here? What did I do? Okay. Like this, with that line over there. And I'm gonna glue it again. Here. Oops. And press it down. And from that opposite side as well. Same way. Yay! Like this. I did it.
Now I'm gonna decorate that edge.
Because even I don't mind too much that here it's that shiny edge from my tape. I would like to decorate it somehow, so I'm gonna use these velvet ribbons, and I think I'm gonna use this one because it will fit there nicely. Yeah, this teeny tiny. And I'm gonna place it from one edge to another, like this. Press it down properly. Cut those excesses. I will use them somewhere, like decoration, these small pieces. They are brilliant for your tags, for small embellishments. Even bits like this, they can be used somewhere, sometimes. I'm terrible saver. I'm shaving everything. You know, what's funny is that my son's now, like, infected by me. Because they ordered some goodies for me for Christmas. And they even saved those envelopes, those Amazon envelopes for me. Because they... that I'm gonna use them. I did. I already used them. So my sons are infected. So I decorate this edge. Now I'm gonna fit that envelope here. Like this. I already cut these corners because I like it more with those round corners, and I used again distress ink, that walnut stain from Ranger, and I'm gonna glue it down. I think I lost the end. Oh, it here? Is it? Is it? Yes, it is. Oh, man. I'm gonna glue it down. Oops. No, don't. Here. Like this. Flat it down. And if you will try to use these tapes, make sure you're gonna press it properly. You're gonna all those bubbles, air bubbles, you're gonna like push them out from that tape, from that space. Then it shouldn't felt out. And from here, I'm gonna place the this clear tape again here. And as you can see, this way I don't even have to bother if I will glue this bottom, which I could, because it's glued from both sides, so nothing will fall out from that bottom part of my envelope. I'm gonna press it down properly and we will continue. Well, I'm back. This is after few hours late. It's nearly dark outside. I'm so sorry. We had Christmas visitors. So I'm gonna continue with this page. I already prepared a piece of book page I would like to put here. I distressed all those edges and I put double-sided tape on this side. I've got double-sided tape on all sides because here it's that clear tape, and double-sided tape will stick properly on that clear tape, not liquid glue. And here on those edges, to make sure it will hold properly, I will put liquid glue. I will place it like this. And in the book you saw before, I had here two pockets, and behind that was another pocket. How you can create it? Today I would like to do something different. But how you can create it? These I made from small envelopes, this pocket, and then I create tag for that. To create two pockets with another pocket behind, you will need just position your envelopes the way you want it. I guess I can distress them to make sure you will see that better. I distress these edges so you will see that better. When you glue down your page, then you need to position your pockets. Maybe like this. put glue here. Let it dry and then put glue on that rest of that first, or that on that top pocket, and glue it down. And you have size of pocket you want to have here. And then just put glue here on that top edge and on that bottom edge, and also on the edge here to make sure it will not go through to that. It will be like belly band if you will put glue just here on the top and on the bottom. It will be like belly band. If you will put glue on that third side, it will be like pocket. So you will have pocket here and then pocket here. But today I would like to do something different, because I've got here this beautiful image. This is John Napier. And what I read here, John Napier was that vintage geek. I don't know how to explain it. He was mathematics, and you will probably read that better without me. Come on, zoom. Here you can see he's been in arithmetics and in, where is it, where I did read that? Trigonometry, yeah. Trigonometry and so many things. He was probably a very brilliant man. So I would like to keep it here, because this book will be about specimen, about probably those vintage geeks, those antique geeks. I forgot to have a look on that right English word for these people, these very clever people, but I hope it's not far from that geek. So I would like to keep that this and with that explanation as well. I will I will again use this pocket here, but I would like to have it like open double pocket. I would like to create here another pocket, so I'm gonna take some book page. Maybe, oh, here is history. Okay, I can use this one. History, what we've got here, a period of transition. I'm gonna use this one. Okay, period of transition. And I'm gonna glue it to my pocket from this side with that bottom left, because this I will use like my pocket here. I glued that down. Now I'm going to cut this half circle, and I'm gonna position to that my button punch. Oops, where it is? I lost it, okay. And here I found whoops. I need this pocket white exactly this way. But oops, look, that envelope is smaller. So when I will fold it down and I will want to create that pocket, I'm gonna fold it down here. I'm gonna make it stronger with my clear packing tape. Again, I think I'm gonna put that packing tape from this side. Yes, probably from this side. So I'm gonna distress that first. What I'm gonna do? I'm not sure what I'm gonna do, because it's I'm gonna have pocket like this. So what I'm gonna do, this will be here, then here I need pocket like this. I can cut it just a little bit on this side. All right, so I guess I'm gonna use this edge like my embellishment. Why not? I'm gonna use this my template for tabs, because I love tabs. I'm gonna take my pencil, draw a tab here like this. Oh, first I have to put there the double-sided clear tape to make it stronger, this one. I will distress all edges. I distress these three edges. Now I'm going to cut this around my envelope. I'm gonna leave there that tab. It will be just like decoration. Maybe I will put there some embellishment, I don't know yet. And I'm gonna finish right here on the bottom, where is my fold. Here is that fold of my book page. So I'm gonna cut it right here. You've got that clear tape, so it's a little bit stronger. And now I need to, pardon me, put that paper in the size I can fit on my page. So I'm gonna use this like my template. I'm gonna cut this edge off my pocket. So my base will look like this. I'm gonna distress all these edges. So I've got to distress all these edges, and now I'm gonna plan. I will glue it down to make pocket here. I still have to remember that this is just book page, just very old book page, and it's fragile. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut a piece of probably cardstock. I guess it will be cardstock to make it a little bit stronger with tap here, because I like taps. And it's beautiful embellishment. So I'm going to have a look. Have a look. How big is this one? It's not too big. Okay, I'm gonna cut a piece of cardstock a little bit bigger than is this one. This is 3 inches. So I'm gonna cut cardstock 3.5. Because that half inch will be the top. You can use also some coffee dyed paper, but right now I don't have any around me, so I'm gonna use cardstock. Yes, here I will create that top, and I want to show you. Oh, my sons are awesome. They bought me another tool. I'm going to create tap. Here I supposed to place it in the middle. Good. I hope it will be okay. And I'm gonna create tap 3.5, a little bit bigger. Good. Yay. It's so easy. Easy peasy. This is amazing tool. I will have to switch on my lights. I'm gonna cut this small piece. Oh, oops. Okay. Yay, look at that. That's so amazing. I like it. Yes. And I will glue my book page on this cardstock, and it will make that stronger, you know. It will be protected, the book page. I don't like to ruin it. So I'm gonna glue it down on my cardstock. Straight away, or I will leave there small piece. I think I will leave there that small piece. I had to switch on my lights because it's getting there really fast. So I distressed these edges, and I glued down that piece of cardstock. It will be positioned like this. Here I will have this page, and this supposed to hold somehow. If I will have there the tack. Oh, go there, please, go there. Oh, come on. I will have that stuck. It took me nearly 1 minute to put it inside. Yeah. Next time I have to cut half circle just on one side, that other side left full, because then I can slide it like this. Yes, see now. Wee. Oh my. So I can put some kind of that sliding closure, that mini tap. I can put here. I think I will do that. Yes, I will do it that way. I will put some something probably there. Probably yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it will be nice decoration. Here will be this decoration. Okay. So we've got pocket here. I'm gonna make around it these corners because here is rounded as well. Show me. I'm gonna leave this corner like it is. So now I need to make small mark where to place my brat. I think a good position will be just right here. Right here first. Okay. I'm gonna make a hole through to that paper. Will I? No, it's so fragile paper. If I will put their brat, it will fall out because those brats are kind of heavy in compared to that fragile, to that strongest of this paper. So I have to do something a little bit different. I'm gonna glue two together. I'm gonna distress it again with a walnut stain later on. Now I have to take some small piece. Sometimes I'm saving like this. These are when I've got rest of a paper and I don't wanna throw it away. I'm cutting anyway, you know, I'm cutting pieces anyway, and I do have few pieces which looks like this, so maybe I can use it somehow. Probably not these. I'm gonna use again these pieces. This is too fragile. This one, it's nice cardstock. It will make also decoration. Oops, something fell down. I think my spray fell down. I've got hairspray right here in my table. Because when I print it on acetate pieces, I use that hairspray. Can make it like embellishment. Like extra embellishment. This way or this way. I don't like it here. I will have to find something different. Well, I found this. This is from Sizzix dies. Those mini dies. Oh. There is third one. But I think it's Sizzix, is it? Pen to US. US. I hope it's Sizzix. I'm saying that right. Hopefully I'm saying that right. I think it's Sizzix, those mini dies. Oh, no, spellbinders. Sorry, spellbinders. These are spellbinders. There is one more smaller. So I think it's this size. Yes, it's this size. I've got half of it here. And I like it more. You will have a look. This shape is much more nicer here. It will be like it will be like decoration when I will open it. It will look really good. And I'm going to use a stamp. I've got here Stamper Anonymous. This was gift. This was so amazing gift from Evie. Evie, thank you so much. Thank you so much for all those gifts. I'm always using all of them. They're amazing. So I'm gonna use Stazon. I like this image the most from what I've got there. Because there is no, you know, on some of these stamps, it's also a bus number something or station, bus station. But here, it's just number and service. So it can be used. It can be used like in any other projects, not just travel projects, which is totally brilliant. Okay. Gonna place it back. Go on your place. Stay there. Now I have to poke a hole, and I'm gonna show you. This is piece, it was longer, and my sons, they are totally in, they are crazy about those armories, old suits for kings and knives. I'm not sure, I think it's armories, the name, and here was small kings. I forgot the name. I hope my sons will don't hear me. Knives? Not knives. Knights? Knights! Not knives! Knights! Small knights. Those metal knights. It was like a display. So I took it because it's brilliant. I poke a hole through to my pieces. And I think... I took it and I think I lost some of these... not knives. Knights. When you don't use some word often, it can be changed. Especially with my English. I think I'm gonna poke the hole right on that number 9. See? Okay, number 9. I've got this huge mess here. Number 9. Poke the hole. Oops. Good. Poke the hole. Take a breath. Oh, I forgot this test. This one. I glued two together because it's stronger. And I wanted to stamp something on it. I will have a look to my stamps and I will stamp something on it. So I stamped there just the pen, ink pen. And I'm gonna glue it just on the top. So I can glue straight away my pages, my papers down. I'm gonna fit this because then I can make right position for my tap. Yes, to make sure it will hold all together. So I'm gonna glue down this first. I'm gonna take off these pieces from my double-sided tape. Now is a double-sided tape. I'm gonna put liquid glue on those three edges where I don't have double-sided tape. Like this. I'm gonna make a nice position for my book page. I think here and here should be straight. This first. Like this, and now I can lay that down. Okay, like this, now I can glue down my pocket. Yes, I'm gonna put liquid glue on these three edges down. I'm gonna glue it down. Oh, here I, on this side, I have to put double-sided tape because is there that clear tape. So I have to make sure it will glue down. Hey, come here. Come here. Go there. This. Take it off. Okay. I have to put glue on this side again because I wipe it with my finger. So here again. Oops. Oops-la. Now I'm gonna glue this pocket like this. Hopefully it will be straight. Put this down. So we've got we've got pocket here and we have pocket here. Now I need to put my holder for this tab somehow. Did I place it too much? Show me. Will we fit? Will we fit? Right here. Yes, we will. Oh, good. This way. I'm gonna put liquid glue on my piece of label. And I'm gonna glue it down. Make sure that it will hold properly. This way. And it will hold my tag as well. Also, if I will open, yes, I have still. Good. So this way it will hold my pocket. It will make nice decoration. Like this. Yay! Oh, yeah, good. It's still pocket. I can still open it and continue my decoration here. Now I scared myself. Sometimes it happened that I forgot something. This I can glue right here. Yeah, I need to stamp something here. Some nice meaningful something. I still don't know what I will put there. I was thinking about so many options, but I don't have so many signs on my stamps. I've got more backgrounds or images. Okay, now I'm dealing with small problem. I tried to stamp that with this piece of acrylic block to stamp this Tim Holtz stamp, that Telegram stamp from this beautiful collection, this collection of stamps. It's very old, but I still like it. I like anything from him. Here is number of this collection, and because it didn't stamp properly, I have to place it to my stamp this tool. But look at this, I can't hold my piece with my magnets because it's smaller. So what I'm gonna do, it's maybe small advice, because it will still be glued down, so I don't mind too much if I will destroy background of this label. I'm gonna put small piece of double-sided tape on the background. I'm gonna glue it down on this cardstock. I'm gonna hold my cardstock with these two magnets, and now hopefully I can stamp it a few times to make sure. I'm gonna try to position that on that position before. Hopefully I'm kind of right position. Hopefully, I will see. And I'm gonna try to stamp it with this tool. It's what I said before, I am so bad with stamping, like handy stamping. It's still not right. What's wrong with my inks? Come on. Oh, okay. It's sticky, but it... Oh, shoot. Okay. I'm gonna change this label totally, somehow, later on. What I can do with you? What I can do with you? I know what I'm gonna do with this. I'm gonna use Idea Patina, Rusty Patina. I'm gonna make it like a metallic plate. I'm gonna try this one. Dokraft Jet Black. Hopefully I've got here somewhere another one. Do I have? Yes, I do. I'm gonna distress this a little bit. Not. Okay, I'm gonna distress it again. Yes. I think I need not new tool, but I need new inks. They are totally dry, all of them. And I'm so surprised because our house, it's very, very wet. Okay, will be possible to stamp it now. I'm gonna try it on some cardstock. On background, I'm gonna try it on background. On backside, not background. Show me how you stamp. Mm-hmm, let's see. Right, I've got new pad, ink pad, again from Dokraft. It looks like this will be stamping. If not, I'm not gonna stamp there anything at all. Alright, try it again. Nowhere here. Yeah! It's there, it's there. And I'm already dirty from that ink. Yay! Yay! Good. I'm gonna keep this ink outside because I know it's stamping. It's stamping, it's good. We've got one which works. That's brilliant. Okay. Gonna put this on right space because other way I will lost it really fast. Go there. Good. Oh. And we will fit this one. I'm not sure if it's dry. Maybe I will wait a little bit more to make sure it's dry. Here, I am not sure yet. I will definitely decorate this. Somehow, I am not sure yet. Maybe I will make some tap here. Probably I will make some tap here. This I will keep like it is now. We can move on to here. You can make this like photo space, photo album. To place here pieces of white paper. It's good, just normal printer paper. To cut it to sizes of your future photographies and place it here. I think I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna use this stamp to make sure it looks like for photography. I'm not sure. I'm gonna show you how it looks like. This is beautiful stamp. Unfortunately, I don't know from where it is because I said that many times. I'm buying from craft room clearance, and many times it came pieces together without any branch, you know, in one bag or in one pocket or in one box. And this is stamp I bought with so many other silicone stamps, so I'm not sure where from it is, but it's beautiful. And I saw in many videos of ladies who are making photo albums that they kind of helping with stamps like this to show where the position of photographies should be. And it's very clever. It's a very clever idea. I like that idea. So I'm using it. So I'm gonna put here my papers. Pardon me. Where I think those photographies can be. And I will be back. Step back. I'm not gonna place here any photo mats. Because this journal will be in that vintage style. Maybe that the future owner of this journal will do not decide to put there any pictures. So it have to be optional. So what I was thinking, I'm gonna put something like papers, folded papers here, and the future owner can choose if some photos will be put inside. So I try to do something like this. I'm gonna show you just half of step how I did it, because the second half is very awkward. I used this envelope punch I've got now. It's by the way We Are Memory Keepers envelope punch, and it's a really awesome tool. Your tops are very quickly done. So I halved my piece of coffee dyed paper. I have the paper. Now I have to take some cardstock, because that paper, it's very soft, and that punch will do not punch it properly. So I'm gonna take a piece of cardstock. This here, I'm gonna make that tab. So I'm gonna place it here. If yes, in the middle, punch. Now I'm gonna open it, because that other half, I'm gonna make like notebook, this one, and I can't show you how I made it, because my punch, it's terrible. Oh, here, it's terrible, terrible, terrible. It's really awkward how I am using it, but I will ask you for help, maybe you will know. I think 2 inches will be okay. This I'm gonna cut out. On this other side, I would like to make like notebooks, the trip notebook. But I'm gonna ask you for something. I've got this Fiskars Teresa Collins punch for that notebook. But I'm not sure what I have to buy for that, because it came like this, and I was totally confused how I will use this one. It doesn't have that top. And then I've got from another Fiskars punch, which broke. I saved this one. So now I am using it like punching this way, but it doesn't work properly. It's always sliding everywhere, and it's really awkward to see me to work with this. But if anyone knows what I have to use for this one, can you somehow help me, please? That will be really amazing. So I'm gonna try to punch this here, and I will be back. Yay! I did it! Oh, here I have to cut that piece out. This is probably for first time, but it actually looks like ripped from some notebook. I'm gonna cut this piece out. Okay. Now what I'm gonna do, I've got some embellishments made out of those cutouts from my book pages. I just cut like that fishtail piece of book page, and another smaller piece of book page I cut again in that fishtail, I think. And then I glued them down, and I put this brat on it. It's a very quick embellishment, and I'm using those cutouts or those rests. That's crap. All that crap I'm trying to use. So I'm gonna glue it here. Like embellishment. Maybe I can leave there that number 33. It's another decoration, right? I'm gonna glue this on my page. It already on that page like this, because it's from very soft teeny tiny paper. Teeny, I think. Not thick, thin paper. I didn't make any pocket behind, because I will have to back it with some stronger paper. But you can do it. If you use some stronger paper, just do it. Just make it like another pocket, and you can slide some tag behind. And then I cut out that stamp I showed you. So I cut it out, and now it's gonna be optional, you know. Now I can put it right here with paper clip. And here we've got options. You can put your picture here. It will be closed. Here I will put, I think I'm gonna use this one. And I'm gonna decorate it somehow, to use it for a closure here. Yes, I will. Yes, I will. What we've got here? I've got so many scraps here around me. Nope, 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 nope. okay, I'm going to use this label, but it will be like my background. I found in my stuff this vintage label, not sure where from. I think I've got it from Graphic Fairy website. They've got amazingly beautiful dies and everything like that. So I think I've got it from there. I'm gonna glue down first this one, and I'm gonna put my brat through to these holes to fit it to that page. I think I'm gonna place it like this, so it will peek out a little bit from this side. So I have to distress it with that walnut stain as well. So I glue it and fit those brats around. And now I'm going to place here this label, and I'm gonna glue it just on this book nameplate, or how it's called. So this will be like a tuck spot. So if some picture should be placed here, it can be slide just behind. Do not glue at all to that page, and it still can be that rest of that page, like journaling spot. Oops, not there. I think right here. Yay! stay. See? And I forgot to put there my closure. Aha! And this way I'm creating journals for a month, sometimes longer, because I always forgot something. Here I'm gonna use some small cup, and I'm gonna use it like a closure for my page. These are Tim Holtz tucks and tabs, and I'm going to use the shorter one. Okay, I'm gonna use this short one. Ah, this is nice. I like it. Yes, this one. It's nice. It's beautiful. Okay, I'm gonna just distress it. I'm not gonna put there anything, because here is some writing, here is writing. So I'm gonna use this one just like it is. I'm gonna distress it from other side as well. And because holding just small paper, I think it's good if it's just from one cardstock. Oh, okay. And I'm gonna fit it again. This video will be very long, very long. Come on, Evie. Whew, that was a hard job. Now, I'm gonna make something here. Here I've got another one. It's exactly the same. I think I'm gonna place it here on the bottom. But here I would like to have it like a pocket. Oh, probably like top on pocket. Yes, it will be like top on the pocket. Here I will place this pocket, and this will be on the top, just like journaling spot. And here I was thinking to use some book page, and I've got here this beautiful history, and I actually already folded down, so I'm gonna make it like a pocket here, like this. I'm gonna distress all these edges, and I will be back. Okay, I distressed all edges on this piece. I also placed there this piece of normal printer paper, like photomat, but I still want to do pocket here. And I thought I'm gonna decorate this pocket with that label, but it's like vanished on that. So I have to somehow decorate it. So I found this piece of normal coffee dyed paper. You can use this way loads of your scraps. And I think this way it will be same, but yeah. I'm gonna glue this on that paper. And I'm not gonna cut that coffee dyed paper. I'm gonna use it like my another writing spot. I'm gonna use the. I need to make a bigger hole in that glue. This is ridiculous. It's still going so slow. Now I'm gonna fold it in the same position, maybe, hopefully. Make like frame around. A little bit more. Okay. Like this. Okay. Match those edges. Will that be okay? I'm gonna fold it. And here I still have a piece. So I'm gonna fold that piece as well. Mm-hmm. Make it even, right? This way. Yes, hopefully. This way. And now what I can do now, it will be like a fold here, and it can be like a fold here. Okay, it will be like double space for writing. Here, to close it, I'm gonna use another tab from Tim Holtz. Tabs and dies, or tacks and tabs, big die. I'm gonna use this, because I used that before. Here you can see it's wrong shape. They're probably just end of my cardstock, or that cardstock moved. So I'm gonna cut this out. I'm saving always. I'm saving even wrong cuts, because you never know. You never know. Maybe you will use it. And this style I used already before. Oh, also one tap. Which will be nice here. I guess this will be nice here. Yes. This shape will be good here. I will find some stuff with probably ideas or something like that. And I'm gonna glue it right here. I'm gonna stamp it first. Well, I choose this arrow. It's from another Tim Holtz collection. This is very old collection. This is very old collection. And I think I lost... Oh, here. Oops. The Journey. This collection, it's called The Journey. I hope you will see that. Oh, what? What my camera just did? Here, The Journey. It's called this collection of stamps. So I use that arrow stamp. I already poked a hole to this tab. I'm gonna fit it with the brad. With that brad. Fit it like this. Flat it down. And now to make sure I can fit all together. Okay, I'm gonna glue this one down. Maybe I can do it like a pocket, because here it's that paper, it's fold, it's not this edge, so here it's not any danger that it will be ripped immediately, so I can make it like a pocket, like teeny mini pocket. Gonna glue this on my book page pocket, and I think I will have to finish that video soon, because my sons was visiting me already twice. I think they are getting bored. So we will probably go to play cards. I love to play poker, but I don't know that poker. I don't have that bright poker face. I'm always, yay, you got something, and they know. Actually always win. And I'm gonna slide this right next to my paper. Hey, go there. Go there. Oh, no. This is too much. This is too much. Not over that paper. Come on, Evie. You want to open it, right? I think this way it will be better. Hey. This way. Open it. Glue it down. Yeah. Oh, and I've got that Dawcraft ink, and that ink dries a little bit slower than Stazon ink. So now it really look vintage. Now I can close it. So we've got pocket here. On the top, do I have some small tuck? This is too big. I think. Nearly there. Nearly. Show me. We've got pocket here. Yes. And we have closure here. Go there. Oh, I don't want to touch that arrow. Now we can glue it down. And because I doubled that paper with that copy printer paper, I think maybe I can do some pocket. Now I'm gonna try to use this one. I will see. I think here I will place it one to that mark, that one, number one. I will see. If, I like that. And again, I'm gonna flip it over. And again, this end I'm gonna place on that number one. And now I'm gonna cut those two pieces. I will have to use my scissors and hope in the best. Oh, I like that. Oh, I like that. I like that too. Show me. And we've got pocket. See, here will be pocket. And it's doubled with that printer paper. I'm gonna distress this edge a little bit. I'm gonna put glue. Oh no, first I have to glue this pocket here. So I'm gonna put glue here and here. Okay, I'm gonna glue this. We've got so many pockets. So many pockets here. It's pockets everywhere. And I really like that envelope punch board. I do. I didn't do envelope yet. I think it will come. Maybe I will do for this journal some envelope from book page. Or I definitely will. I'm gonna glue it down. And we will see, right? So we've got here writing space. Oh my. Writing space. And we've got pocket here and pocket there and pocket here. Large one. Good. I like it. The other side, maybe I should. I don't like that, you know, that empty space behind. It's like empty. Maybe I can still do something. I can still do something with it. Very slowly. I'm gonna use this one. Just quick embellishment. Just very quick embellishment. It back. I will have to use again probably that glue, the tacky glue. No, it looks good. Yeah, I like it more. And also, I'm gonna put a piece of that tape. Will I somehow? I can't hear. Okay. Match it together. I'm gonna put a piece of this tape also here to continue that that pattern somewhere else, not just on that base. Oh, stay. Stay right next to my embellishment. Like this. I'm gonna cut those pieces out. Yes, and we've got similar pattern here and here. So it's going together much more better than if it will be just plain. I will have tag here. I've got closure here. I didn't have to put here closure, as I can see now, because that tag will probably hold all that page. And there I can put that. Camera. Hey, go there, go there. Got the camera there. So we've got, we finished this page. Now that other page. What I will do here. I was thinking here to place this, right? And this one like writing space. But because this is smaller, you know, it will be like a step, and it's breaking that comfort of normal writing. So I have to came up with something different. So I went through to my book, to my old book, and I found this beautiful page, and I would like to use this picture. I really would like to use this picture, and but I'm thinking to place it here to keep this picture, because I really like that. And when I fold it half, it was stuck with this sentence: history occupies a more important place in the field of knowledge. And I really like that sentence, so I would like to keep that sentence as well, because I hope this book will be in some kind of theme of knowledge of people who invented things. Even maybe I will don't use proper images for that, probably not, but you know, at least to keep some kind of book pages which are related to this. So I had to destroy my my notebook punch, because when I tried to place it here, it was covered that history sign, which I really like. So, and how I will keep this picture? I can sew this through that book page, but because it's a really fragile book page, I will probably use again my clear tape, and I will glue it to my book page. But because I like to keep that history in some kind of frame, I'm gonna cut those white edges first, then I'm gonna draw the shape of that tab underneath. I'm gonna show you what I mean. I'm gonna cut those edges first a little bit, just make a frame around that history picture. Yeah, like this. Now I'm gonna place it on. Yeah, it's still there. Good. It's still here, that H. I'm gonna place it here, so it's gonna be probably on this place. Yes, it will be here. I'm gonna fold it over. Now I need to take pencil and draw a shape of this tap. So I will have to cut. First, I'm gonna cut that this page, and then I will see how much it will take from my history sign. Because I wanna keep that sign there, so I will see what shape I will create from that history sign. Shape it just a little bit with my scissors, and now through the light I can see here I've got Y, that last letter from history, and I would like to keep it there. So I have to create my own tab. I'm gonna copy that first. Just a little bit along, not properly. And then I'm gonna flip it over. I'm not gonna flip it over. I'm gonna draw, I guess, the edge. It's here. It's finished here. Okay. I'm gonna draw it. No, it's too much. Here, it's finished. Okay. So here. Okay. Oh, my drawing. It's terrible, terrible, terrible. Hopefully, my fussy cutting will be better. I can just hope for that. Whoops. We save it. Yes. I'm gonna distress all these edges. So I distress all these edges. And now I think I'm gonna glue it down. Yes, it will be okay. Can I open it? No, if I will glue it all on that, I can make pocket from that underneath as well. Oh, I know, I can make, again, multi pockets. And also, I can make this stronger using this envelope. It's envelope. Okay. I'm gonna put glue on all that top properly to make sure all that top will be glued nicely. Like this. If I will glue it this way, I wanna have glued this side. Okay, I'm gonna glue this side as well, and I'm gonna glue bottom as well. This is top. I'm gonna glue it. Pardon me. This is top. Yeah. So I'm gonna place it right on the this edge. Make sure that edge will be a little bit stronger because of all that envelope on it. So we have pocket here. We have pocket here. We will have pocket here for a tag. And if I will glue it, where is it? Oh, here. If I will glue it on these three sides, I will have pocket from the top as well. I need to somehow decorate that background. I'm gonna use those washi tapes. And I would like, I wanna share with you something what was happened to me a few days ago. I'm not sure how this was happened, but I somehow took half of one layer of my washi tape with that previous layer, and look what was happened to me. It was like ripped my washi tape on three different layers. Here is normal washi tape, here is that between, and here is without print. I was totally surprised how this was happened. So I think I'm gonna just glue it right here, but because this side doesn't have any glue. It's too long. It's too long. I'm thinking too many hours about this one. I'm gonna put the double-sided tape. I'm gonna give it a try to make it straight. I'm gonna put the double-sided tape, and I'm gonna glue it down on that page. Nearly, I've got small edge. You know, if this will be some shabby chic, I will use gold glitter and I will glitter this edge. But because it's not shabby chic, I have to cut this piece of double-sided tape. Not sure if you can see that glare. Here is a piece of double-sided tape, so I'm gonna cut it out. Now I'm going to glue it down. Hopefully the double-sided tape will hold properly. Probably here. Like this. And I'm gonna use another one. This one. I'm gonna use this pointing hat. I believe this is from Tim Holtz collection of washi tapes. So I'm gonna use this. I think it can end right here. Pull it up slowly. And here on the top, I think I'm gonna place this one like decoration. Yes, I'm gonna put this like decoration on that end. Like this, it will a little bit peek out on that other side. More on this. Like this. I have to place it this way because I can't see properly. Now I lost what I wanted to put there. Where is it? Oh, I lost it. Where is my envelope? I did lost it. I had it just right next to my hand. This is ridiculous. I have to finish this video right now. So now I can glue it down this way. And I think it's decorated just enough. Because here will be some tucks in the pocket. Here will be something. And I will decorate that pocket later on as well. So I'm gonna glue it down. Maybe I will use also some stamps. I didn't decide that yet. I will see, but for now, I'm gonna glue this as my pocket. To match it with that background. Like this. I'm gonna glue this using this beautiful clear tape, and I think I'm gonna glue it just on that edge, so I have to use my corner punch. Corner punch. Oh, I'm sorry. And I'm gonna glue it here using this clear tape. So first I will put clear tape on this piece from one end. So now that I'm gonna copy this line down there. And now I'm going to glue it to that bottom book page. I think I'm gonna just copy that bottom part. That line, not bottom part. That line over that book page. Flip it over, match it together and fold down that tape like this. So I've got two writing spaces which are holding on the clear tape. I will have to think about some holding here, do not fly it like this. I will have to think what I'm gonna use. Maybe I will make some pocket here as well. I'm not sure yet. For now, I'm gonna leave it because it's really too many hours. I'm just gonna show you what I will add to this pocket. I found a while ago, I print those silhouettes and I never use them and I really like them. So here, I think I'm gonna place this. Look at that cabinet card. That's so hilarious. So I'm gonna place that cabinet card here. And also this gentleman's silhouette here. How beautiful is it? Or maybe I can place him here. The large pocket. Ooh, that's nice. I will see how I will place them. So for now, I'm gonna leave it like it is. I'm gonna continue. I think tomorrow, hopefully, I will see. I'm gonna place here this. But now I'm gonna glue it first. Oh, no, I'm gonna distress one edge first to make sure if it will peek out, it will be this way. Yeah, a part of that will peek out from other side. Now I can glue it down. Uh-huh. Just bear with me. Come on. Why are you dry so fast? I'm gonna place that. Oh, it's working now. Good. Place glue here. I'm gonna glue this down. This one. I'm gonna let it dry before I will put the brads, but I will do it same way like this. And I'm gonna have a look on that cover how it holds. You know, I never used that gel before. How I will hold it, how I can. Yeah, it's good for now. Oh, it holds. It holds properly. That's good. Well done. So for now, I'm gonna use Idea Patina Ferro. It's iron. Iron base. And it's a very thick paint. You have to use it like it is because that thickness will give you that metal look. So I'm gonna paint with this metal paint here and there, also around my label. It's beautiful, very thick paint, and I use it many times before, and I really like that paint because when you use that rusty effect on it, it makes beautiful effects, really amazing rusty effects. Maybe a little bit on those strings. Now I'm gonna use a rusty effect. I'm gonna just wipe a little bit my brush because you will see what I made with my rusty patina. Look, look at that color. It should be blue. It's not anymore. So I left there very dirty brush inside. That was really bad. Now I'm gonna put a little bit of that rusty patina. This is, I'm gonna show you later, not now, or I will spill it all over. And you will see in that next video how this cover will looks like, how that rusty patina works, because it's really too long, too late now, and I'm going to offer my sons if we will play poker. I like the poker, to make them a little bit busy, you know. I think for now I'm okay. I'm gonna let it dry. I know we didn't make too many steps forward, but I hope you find some inspiration. I will definitely come back again because I was thinking for a very long time to show you how I work. I know it's taken a really long time. I'm overthinking mostly too much, but still I hope you find some inspiration. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all your amazing comments, for all your support. It's after Christmas, I think, I believe for all of us who celebrating Christmas, it's already after Christmas. Can you believe that? That Christmas are gone for this year. I can't wait to next month. So Merry Christmas once again. I hope you've got wonderful holidays. I hope you are enjoying your friends, your families. Take care, people, and see you next time. Bye.